Hi, welcome to Tamer Yoga. You're going to need two blocks today. This flow is going to be about a 15-minute one, and it's just going to be focused on the hips. First, let's come into tabletop, and we're just going to go through a couple cat-cows. On our exhale to start, we're going to round through the tailbone, and through the entire back, looking towards the belly button. On an inhale, you're gonna drop the belly button, lift the tailbone to the sky, lift the head up, shoulders away from the ears. So again, rounding completely, pulling the belly button in. And then pulling those ears away from the shoulders. Cycle through a couple of these. Feel free to move side to side if that's what feels good for you. I like to wag the tail as it's said. And then go through a couple little pelvic circles. We're gonna step back with our right foot, toes on the ground, and we're gonna reach the heel back. So you're straight from the shoulder all the way to the heel, and you're gonna get a stretch here in the back of the calf. On an inhale, you're going to bring your knee towards the wrist, and then send it back again, getting a little stretch. Bring it into the wrist, lift it up to the tricep, back down to the wrist, and step it back. Come back to tabletop and switch sides. Again, reach that heel back and feel that stretch through the calf. And then we're gonna do the same thing. So on an inhale, knee to wrist, exhale, step it back. Inhale, then we're gonna reach it to the wrist, tricep, back down, and then reach it back. Come back into tabletop. From here, you're gonna grab your blocks, keep them handy. You might need them. I definitely do. You don't have to be as awkward as I am moving the block back there, but you know, to each his own. So you wanna get it to about the back bum slash outer hip portion, enough that you can actually sit on it and prop yourself up. The back toes are perfectly straight and flat, so they're not pigeon-toed in. And that front shin is parallel to the front edge of the mat. And I'm just showing that you can drop the block down if you want, but I absolutely cannot. I need to have it there propped up quite high. And then from here, you can fold over the front of your leg. You can move side to side. You can stay upright if things are really tight for you. Find what works for your body. I am definitely a mover and I like to move around in my practice. It feels much better in my hips when I actually move side to side, so that's what I do. Coming back to center, we're going to bend that back left knee, bringing the heel in towards the bum as you reach back with that left hand, grabbing that foot. If this is not possible, don't worry about it. If you have a strap, you can also use that. Quads are usually incredibly tight on most North Americans, so if this is too intense for you, don't worry about it. Just do your best. We're gonna come out of it, and we're gonna go to the other side. So you're gonna move the block to the other side. Not as awkward this time. Again, that front shin is going to be parallel with the front edge of the mat. You can have the block on any height so that you can actually sit yourself up and have that opening. Or if you're super flexible, then you will have no block. And again, you can move side to side on this side. You can bend over that front leg. You can also move the block down at any point in time if you feel a little bit more opening. I thought I did, but I didn't. So if you're feeling a lot of pull in your hips, just notice if you're holding any tension in your jaw and your shoulders, and just try to let that go if that's happening for you. We're going to come up if you're down, and then we're going to bend that back right knee again, grabbing that foot if possible, pulling it in towards the bum. Because I am on the block, it's a little bit easier for me to do this. You might not be so successful. And then we're going to release that slowly, coming out of it, moving the block just to the side. We are going to bring our big toes to touch, knees spread as wide as the mat, sitting the bum towards the heels, reaching the arms forward. Come up onto the fingertips here. We're just going to reach those fingertips forward as far as we can. And then drop back down onto the palms, keeping that same activation in the shoulders. We're going to slowly make our way back up and then come to a seated position. We're going to come to sit. Legs out in front of you, right foot up and over that left thigh, right hand right behind your bum, left arm goes up and twists over that right thigh, looking back over your right shoulder. Inhaling, come out of that twist. We're going to cross that foot over top of that left knee and just bring that foot, sorry, the left foot in towards your bum. So you're going to feel a stretch here in your right hip. I'm just going to turn so you can see. So that shin is parallel, so it's not dropping down or anything. And then that foot is flexed, the right foot. And you can push your bum in towards your heel, lifting the chest up, getting a nice stretch here. Okay, next pose. Left leg out in front of you, and we're going to grab that left ankle, bringing it to the outside of that right thigh. And then right foot is going to come to the outside of the left thigh. So, knees are stacked. That's important. It doesn't matter if they're not right on top of each other because you're super tight. If you are super tight, bring those heels closer towards the hips and lean back. If you have more mobility, open those feet up, and then you're going to just reach over top of the legs and pull yourself down. Okay, now we're going to go to the other side. So, you're going to have the left foot crossing over top of the right thigh this time. Left hand right behind your bum, right arm goes up, and the elbow hooks around that left knee, twisting open. You can hold it a little bit longer than this. I panicked because I thought I forgot a pose. I didn't forget a pose. So, we will move on to the next one, which is the figure four sitting down. Just crossing that left ankle over top of that right knee, and then bring that heel, the right heel, in towards your bum. And again, you can sway side to side. It feels better for my hips when I do that rather than sitting still. And transitioning into the next pose, which we're going to send that right leg out. Grab that right foot and bring it to the outside of the left thigh. And then bring that left foot to the outside of the right thigh. Again, if you're tight, you can have your hands behind you, leaning back. If you're more open, feet go out. And then you just lean over your legs. Also, that is my cat Jake. He's the best. Coming out of that pose slowly, just wiggle those legs out a bit. Then we are going to come into a seated wide-legged straddle. So the toes are pointing up towards the sky, sitting up nice and high on the sit bones. And then you can stay upright here, or you can walk your hands forward, whatever feels good for you. If you are down, we're going to come all the way up and then bring the soles of the feet together in Baddha Konasana. So the heels are close in towards the pelvis, knees are opening up, clasping the bottom of the feet, and using the elbows to push the hips open, leaning forward slightly. Coming up and out of that, we're going to move on to our next pose. So you can go up to a wall. Or a couch if you have one close, bend, chair, honestly, it doesn't even matter. You're just gonna lay back and put your feet up on whatever you have. You just want a 90-degree angle in your legs. Bring your right foot to cross over top of the left thigh, flexing that right foot. You're just going to push the knee away from your body using the strength in your outer right thigh. And it's optional to just bring your left knee in towards the chest, give it a little squeeze before switching to the other side. Left ankle over top of the right knee, and again, using the strength in the outer thigh, just push that left knee away from your body towards the couch. Again, optional is to bring that knee in towards your chest for a wee little squeeze and then releasing it down. We're just going to come into half happy baby. So that left knee is going to come into that left armpit. The left heel is pointing up to the sky. The right leg is dropped down just below our bum with the knee out to the side. And then we're going to slowly switch by bringing the right knee in. Releasing the left foot down. Again, right knee in towards the armpit, heel towards the sky. Relaxing the left leg. And then bringing the left knee in towards the armpit, we're going to come into full happy baby. Heels pointing up to the sky. Trying to get the tailbone to stay on the ground. And our next pose, the feet are going to drop, soles of the feet together, knees are splayed out into reclined Baddha Konasana. If you're really tight on the inner thighs or the outer hips, you can grab your blocks and place them underneath your knees on any height that you need. Place them however you need to be able to completely relax your legs. Once you are comfortable, we're going to stay here for our Shavasana. It's short but sweet. Grab a blanket or a pillow if you need. Relaxing the tension in your neck and your jaw. Bringing your awareness to your breathing. Practicing some diaphragm breathing. or just connecting with your body. If you want some more time in Shavasana, pause the video. Otherwise, we're going to slowly bring our awareness back to the body, bringing some movement by bringing the knees together in towards the chest, crossing the ankles, and rock up to a seated position. Thank you for practicing with me. I hope you feel better. Namaste.